People often confuse the terms center of gravity and the centroid. This happens because when you are dealing with the homogeneous material, center of gravity and the centroid are the same. Consider this square. The center of gravity and the centroid of the square are the same, right in the middle. Don't let this fool you. Center of gravity, as you know, is a point where you can apply the total weight and balance the body. Centroid, on the other hand, is the geometric center of the body. To make the difference clear, let's consider a different square. This is still a square, but half of it is heavier than the other half. I made it heavier by adding another layer of material on top of it. In real life, you may have a scenario where you are using two different materials, such as concrete and steel, used together in construction, or wood and metal. In this case, the centroid will be still in the middle, as it is the geometric center of the square, but the center of gravity moves towards the heavier side. Those two points are shown here. And as you can see, they are not the same. I can balance the shape using the center of gravity and not using the centroid. You can see that these two points are apart. The concept of centroid is widely used in engineering applications. All engineering students must know how to determine the centroid of various geometric shapes. It is easy to find the centroid of simple shapes. If an object has an axis of symmetry, then the centroid will always lie on that axis. If an object has two axes of symmetry, then the centroid will be at the intersection of those axes. For a square, the centroid is always at the intersection of two axes of symmetry, which is right in the middle of the shape. For a circle, centroid is always at the center. You can apply this principle for any object and figure out the centroid without doing any mathematical calculations. However, for composite shapes, we will follow a simple step-by-step procedure to determine the centroid. We will do that in the next video.